In this video, we're going to decide whether R omega, with its three different topologies, and RL are connected. Let's start with the simple one, that is RL. RL is very easy to see that it's not connected because it can be written as minus infinity, 0, union, 0, plus infinity. Obviously, these two sets are open because we're talking about the lower limit topology. And they are clearly disjoint. So let's actually get to the important part of the video, that's proving if R omega is connected or not, depending on which topology we're choosing. So let's start with the box topology. In the box topology, R omega is not connected. And the proof for this is not at all trivial. You have to take a very specific set to take as a separation. That set, let's call it A, is going to be the set of bounded sequences. Remember that when we say sequence, it's because we're working in R omega. So X in R omega is of the form Xn for a natural, and so it's a sequence. And obviously the set P has to be the complement of A. So if A is the set of bounded sequences, then B is going to be the set of unbounded sequences. Well, obviously A and B are disjoint, and A union B is R omega. But again, like we saw in the previous video, we have to prove that A and B are open. So what we have to ask ourselves is if they are in our topology. First of all, it suffices to show that one of these two sets is open, because remember that other definition for connectedness, it say that a set is connected if and only if the only open sets are the empty set and the whole space. So if, let's say, that we prove that A is open, then that's it, because we found another set that's not empty and it's not the whole space that is open, and so the space cannot be connected. To prove that the set A is open, we will prove that there is another element in the box topology that is inside A. So this is what we are asking ourselves, and we will prove that there exists U in the box topology such that U is a subset of A. But this is very simple. We will take an element A in A, so a bounded sequence. A is formed by A sub n. And what we can do is take the set U to be a1 minus 1, a1 plus 1, this is just a usual interval in the real line, times a2 minus 1, a2 plus 1, and so on. So obviously this is an element in the box topology, and if I take an element in U, then because I'm always adding and subtracting 1 on each component, then obviously X will be bounded, because remember that A was bounded. And so if X is bounded, then X is an element in A, and then A is open. So given that we were able to prove that it is open, then R omega with the box topology is not connected. Now let's continue with the uniform topology. For this, we will take again the same sets A and B and prove that A is open. So this will give us the conclusion that R omega with the uniform topology is not connected. For this, let's take A, an element in A, so a bounded sequence, and let's take a positive number R, and we will prove that if we take the ball constructed with a uniform metric with center in A and radius R, then this ball is completely contained in A. So for this, let's take X, an element here. But if X is here, that means that the distance between X and A is smaller than R. And then this means that the bounded metric between each of the components is also smaller than R. But then if this happens, then the sequence xn is also bounded, because A was bounded and X is not further away than R from the sequence of A. And so A is open. And with this we have that R omega with the uniform topology is also not connected. Let's finish the video by proving what happens with the product topology. And this proof is again not trivial at all, but with the product topology, it is connected. To prove this, we're going to define the following set. Rn with subindex n is going to be the set of elements in R omega such that xi is equal to 0 for every I greater than or equal to n. So it's a subset of R infinity, but these sequences only turn 0 from this point onwards. And so what happens with this is, if I have x in this space, then x is like this. It's x1, x2, x3, and so on up to xn, and then it's 0. So the part that actually matters on this element x is here at the beginning, on the first n components. And because of this, we get that this, that Rn, is holomorphous to Rn, but the usual Rn that we have, when Rn would be directly x1 up to xn. You can try and prove this finding the function, but it's actually pretty trivial. And also, R infinity, the set of sequences that are eventually zero, is going to be the union over all the natural numbers of Rn. Given that this set is connected, then this other is connected. And so here we have the union of connected sets with at least one point in common. Because 0 is in Rn for every n. And given that each Rn is connected, this implies that R infinity is connected. And so if R infinity is connected, then R infinity closure is also connected. But remember what set was this? Well, the closure of R infinity we saw in a previous video, that was R omega in the product topology. And so, with all this, we have that R omega is connected. And this is exactly what we were trying to prove. If you like this type of videos and you want to help us support the channel, then you can do so in many ways. You can either donate on Ko-fi or become a member to get access to exclusive content. If in addition to that content you want to have merchandise, then you can become a member on Patreon, where you will get stickers, mugs, t-shirts, hoodies, and more. But if you only want that merchandising, then you can just visit our store, where we have all that merchandise available for everyone to buy.